guys, welcome to this episode of 4-Inch Outdoors. Now in this show, Gamble and I are going to be heading down to Florida in search of some hogs at Swine in the Pines. Now in this particular show, Gamble will be in search of her first ever hog. She'd been on hog hunts in the past, but she'd ran the camera for me. But in this episode, I'm going to put a crossbow in her hands and I'm going to get behind the camera and we're going to see how she does. So just sit back and enjoy.
Well, we're here in Swines in the Pines. We're getting ready to go out. I have never hunted hogs before, so I'm going to get a quick tutorial. He's got us a ground blind set up, and we'll see what we can do.
All right, so the cool thing about pigs is that, especially when you're hunting with a bow, is that it doesn't really matter so much about worrying about where you're going to hit as much as you have more of a surface area here, so everybody wants to hit the shoulder. But the cool thing about shooting with a bow and arrow is that that arrow, when it goes through, it doesn't destroy a lot of the meat and the bone and stuff like that. So I always tell people the easiest way to shoot a pig is go like mid-body. Anywhere mid-body on the pig, right in the shoulder, even low on the shoulder. The bad thing is there's a very dense bone right here. But if you can hit mid-body, high shoulder, or even forward of the shoulder, you'll be fine. The main artery runs right here. The neck kind of turns and comes into here. This area is a bad area. This has a big, just bunch of meat. There's not anything up there that's vital. This is the bad area. We do not want to hit it in the gut, because if you hit it in the gut, it's going to pop out, and usually just an intestine is going to pop out and plug it, and you're not going to find any blood. The bad thing about pigs, though, all their power comes from their back legs. So instead of jumping or ducking a shot, they're gonna push forward. So if you were thinking about shooting a heart shot and he jumps forward, now you got a gut shot, all right? You can still go for the heart shot. You just gotta realize if that leg's back like that instead of being forward, that bone's right there. So if you can sneak one in as he's facing away, a quarter and away shot, and sneak one in there, you'll be better off. Cool?
Alrighty, we'll see how we do. Get it on my arms because it ain't me. My hat nice clean here.
Might be January here in Florida, but there's still bugs, and it is warm today. So, as always, we'll go to our L&M Custom Scents for some protection. Now, once we got settled in the blind, it was time to sit back and wait for the hogs to come filing in.
We are set up here in the ground blinds down in the pines, and Larry's let me go first. We're waiting for him to come in, so we'll see where we go from here.
Deer hunters are always looking for that extra advantage, and here at FRO we are no different. That's why we use Denver's Deer Sense. DDS has a complete line of products that's 100% fresh and pure. So whether it's premium buck, premium doe, estrus, or one of their other great products, you can always get the best with DDS. The SRB Field Rest is perfect for turkey hunting. Be sure to check out their complete line of products at srbfieldrest.com. Now, I know you're thinking exactly what I was as I was sitting behind the camera, and that is pick one and shoot it. But Gamble had her heart set on a big red sow that was working around in the pack of hogs. And of course, it didn't get to be a big red sow without a little smarts. And so I think he kind of knew, you know, to hang back and keep the smaller ones in between it. But she was bound and determined to get that big red sow. Like I said, she was determined to get that big red sow. Well, eventually she gave up on the big red sow, and that's where Sox comes in. A big, big boar who looked like he was wearing four white socks. So when we identified him and he was making himself a little bit more target friendly, it was time to zero in on him. So let's see what happens.
Whether you're hunting or just getting in some practice, I always trust Luminoc to light the way. Light them up.
Minerals are an important part of managing your own land. That's why we trust Rack Tracker Outdoors Minerals and Attractants. RTO allows us to give the deer extra nutrition and antler growth, so we're hunting larger and healthier deer. So the next time you're in need of minerals, reach for Rack Tracker Outdoors Minerals and Attractants. Well, she smokes socks. I mean, she put that dead ringer broadhead and that Luminoc right there on that front shoulder, just like Mark told her to, and it's just perfect. And you know what? I enjoyed watching that so much. I think I want to see it again on Tacticam footage. So one more time, here's Gamble smoking socks. Well, there you go, guys. That was Gamble's first hog, and as you can see, she was extremely excited. And you know, we just had a great time hunting together, and she put a great shot on that hog, and you know, it was just a lot of fun. So there you go. That's the story of Socks the Pig. So as always, I hope you enjoyed today's episode of 4-Range Outdoors.